Hello, my name is Dara. Welcome to Dev Cloud and DevOps Ask Me Anything. I got another question, and the question goes thus: how soon can I learn Azure? And what are the fundamental jobs available for a beginner? Number one, I want to say thank you for your question. It's a very good one. So the first question, I would say you should start learning cloud right away. How soon can you learn? Start right away. Start right now if you haven't started already. And how long it takes to learn cloud, I would say it's all dependent on you and your learning pace. Now, what do I mean by this? Your learning should be at the pace you're most comfortable with. So you might want to say, I want to learn 2 hours every night. I want to learn 1 hour every night or 3 hours every day. Or I want to go through all the modules. Now, to learn Azure, Microsoft has made it simple. You can check out the Microsoft Learn modules on Azure Fundamentals or any Azure technology of your choosing, Azure Developer, Azure DevOps, Azure Data, Azure Security. You can check out any of the Microsoft Learn modules. I'll put a link to Microsoft Learn in the video description and also as part of the pinned comment that I'll put after I record this video. But what I'll say is your learning could take days, depending on what you're learning, could take weeks, and also could take months. But one thing I will advise when you're learning is you should be consistent at it. If you're setting 2 hours every day, try to be religious about it. Try to follow it ruthlessly. 2 hours every day. Well, there are some days you won't feel like, to be honest. It happens to everyone. So I would say those days, give yourself some slack. You know, don't beat on yourself if you're not able to learn that day. There are also streaks I've broken. I've broken a lot of streaks this year or so. I recently broke a 30-day streak, which it made me feel bad. But then I was like, nah, it's just part of life. So if you break your learning streak, it's fine, but get back on it as quickly as possible. And why this is important is the fact that once you break that streak and you start feeling bad, no, I'm not learning anymore, and start getting that bad vibes, you essentially lose the interest in learning. So whenever you break that streak, come back to it. If it's possible, don't break the streak. It also gives you this sort of motivational boost. So pace yourself. Be consistent with your learning, dedicate time or chunks of time to it. And one of the things, and I think this is just a random contribution I'll just put to the question or to the answer to the question, is one of the few drawbacks that I've seen from learners that are new in tech is that they want to get there fast. While this is good, you know, to try to want to be the expert in everything. Remember, the people you look at today, even me myself, I didn't just know all this stuff. I know I don't know a lot yet, to be honest. But the things I know today, I didn't just know them like Thanos will snap his finger. I didn't just know them that way. It took time. It took practice. It took mistakes. It took a lot of effort to actually get there. So if you feel you don't know those things yet, don't feel bad about it. It will take time to get there, to get to that pro level, or dare I call it that God mode, if you want to be in that learning. Every pro you see today, every computer science legend you see today, every programming legend you see today, they were once beginners just like you. So don't be discouraged if you feel like you are not there yet. Just learn step by step, day by day, and you'll get there. So what I'll address also is map out your learning goal. I'm trying to learn to become an Azure developer. What are the things I need to learn? Write it out. Well, the Bible said, make the vision plain so that anyone that sees it can run with it. That's what I will advise you. Like literally, put the vision down. What do I want to learn? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. This is the day I want to finish learning this. Then I move on to this. If you're not able to match up, realign the times. Once you finish an item, pick the next one up if you have more time, or pick it up on your next schedule. And while learning, one of the things I also advise is find practical things to apply your learnings to. It's not enough to just watch the videos on YouTube or Plural sites or any learning websites there or read that blog post. It is essential that you also put those learning to practice. So if, for example, if you learn about Azure storage, for example, put that to learning. Go to the Azure portal. Use the Azure Sailor. Use PowerShell. Use Terraform. Use whatever tool you're learning with. And then practice it. Put it in code. write your JavaScript code, write your C# code to actually practice how to put an image, put a video in Azure Blob Storage, practice the archive tier, practice the cool tier, practice the alt tier. Those kind of things will make the concept sink in more, because practice actually I will get better, not just watching the videos. There are a lot of things I've learned in the cloud that I didn't have to go watch videos or read documentation, so I just knew them by practically just using them. And I can tell you the ins and outs of some of these technologies. Now, to your second question, most beginners would ideally start off in something like an apprenticeship, and this is talking to the job opportunities in the cloud. Depending on where you are now in your career, if you're a beginner, you probably start with an apprenticeship or an internship role. Now, depending on what you've learned, you could start off as a cloud administrator, as a cloud developer, as a security administrator. Now, what I'll do in this video is I'll just give a list, although it's not the most comprehensive one, on the roles you can get depending on what you've learned in the cloud. And I can decide to make this roles into individual videos in the future. If you'd like to do that, let me just know in the comment section and I'll ensure that I try to get to doing that. But here are some of the roles: cloud administrator, site reliability engineer, solutions architect, security specialist, cloud analyst, cloud engineer, cloud developer, compliance specialist, support engineer, quality assurance engineer, product manager. Yes, it can be a product manager in the cloud. Now, I could go into this of all these roles, as I said, but those would be other videos. If you want me to go through those roles in one stretch of video or as individual videos explaining how they apply to cloud, I can do that, but let me know if it's something that is important to you and I'll try to make videos also for those ones. Now, that's it. I hope that answered your question. If you have more dev, cloud and DevOps questions, feel free to send them in the link showing in the video on the screen right now, or scan this QR code right here. And you can also find a link to the questions in the video description and also as a pinned comment. And of course, if you like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and share with your friends. Also, remember to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss any informative videos like this one. Until I come your way again with another video, remember what I say: stay safe and goodbye.